Hi guys, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. I hope that you have enjoyed your Diwali as well. And जो gift मैंने दिया था वो आप लोगों को कैसा लगा? I hope that you all are liking it really well because I have received the comments of students that are liking the session and the students that have not seen the October spotlight session. I would like them to see the session and revise the current affairs of the month of October. Okay, and for today, let's begin the session of November 18, 2020. But before that, those who are coming for the first time can subscribe to this channel and hit this bell notification. Also, you can join this Telegram group where we share free quizzes and we provide guidance and resolve queries of students. Okay, so here is our first question, which is about a national campaign. So do listen to me very carefully. Which of the following organization has partnered with UNICEF to launch the 3-month accelerated campaign on pneumonia under the SARS? Social action and awareness to neutralize pneumonia successful campaign. So first of all, you need to know this thing that this SARS campaign was launched in November 2019 by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. Now from the name itself, it is very evident that the purpose of SARS is to curb pneumonia. And now in the month of November, a 3-month campaign has been launched, which is to spread awareness about pneumonia and to promote early interventions such as detecting symptoms and providing vaccination to children in order to prevent pneumonia and to curb the pneumonia deaths. Now, with which organization has UNICEF partnered to launch this accelerated campaign under SARS campaign? Remember this thing that SARS was launched in November 2019. So the right answer is both A and B. Child and Save the Child. So this stands for Clinton Health Access Institute. Remember the full form as well. Clinton Health Access Institutes. This is the full form of this. And the Save the Children along with UNICEF launched this 3-month accelerated campaign in order to create awareness about pneumonia and to provoke early intervention in order to curb pneumonia. Now guys, such scale of operation that campaigns of such scale are required to curb pneumonia. So there would definitely be some facts related to pneumonia that we should discuss. So let's discuss those facts in the next slide, that why is pneumonia so important and why is it a raging issue. So this health management and formation system is the digital branch of National Health Mission. And this digital branch has provided data that in India, approximately 37 children out of the 1,000 live births under the age of 5 die. So 37 children die in India, and out of these 37 children, 5.3 children die due to pneumonia. So that is why pneumonia is such a raging issue and we need to curb this. 5.3 deaths due to pneumonia. So this is the contribution of pneumonia to deaths of children under the age of 5. And in terms of percentage, it amounts to 15%. So this is the percentage. Remember it as well. So now let's look at the highlighted portions. With SARS, pay attention to this guys. This is important. With SARS campaign, the government aims to reduce pneumonia deaths by 2025 to less than 3. Out of 1,000 live births. So this is the target of India. Remember this target to less than 3 by 2025. Apart from this fact, the other fact of importance is that Madhya Pradesh witnessed the highest number of pneumonia caused child deaths followed by Gujarat. So these two facts are really important for you to remember. I hope that this slide helps you in remembering the facts better. Okay, so now let's move on to the next slide. Which country will host the 13th BRICS summit in 2021? So guys, as we know that BRICS is a grouping of 5 countries, Brazil, Russia, India, China and South Africa. So out of these 5 countries, India is going to host the BRICS summit in 2021. Now from where does this question come up? Recently, that is on November 17, yesterday only, BRICS conducted its 12th summit virtually. And what was the theme of that summit? The theme is you must be thinking that these are the three themes. No, these are not the three themes. This is one theme, but I have broken it into three parts so that you can remember the theme better, because we know that themes are important and SEBI exam is just around the corner. So there are chances that this theme can be asked in the examination. So theme is global stability, shared security, innovative growth. So if you learn it in chunks, then it will be easier for you. So that's all for this. Now let's move on to the next question. Which of the following Indian agency has partnered with World Bank for getting advisory services for asset monetization in India? Now guys, you would be aware of this fact that in last year, the government, central government has announced that it is going to disinvest and earn money from disinvestment of its assets in central public sector enterprises as well as in some other enterprises. So for that, the central government has authorized an agency, and that agency is DIPAM. So DIPAM stands for Department for Investment and Public Asset Management, and this was authorized to conduct the asset monetization, basically to take care of the process of disinvestment. So this is the authorized agency, and it has partnered with World Bank in order to get the advisory services for asset monetization, for the process of asset monetization. I hope that you are clear with this fact. There is nothing much explanation required. But this DIPAM comes under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Now you have to tell me that who is the minister of this ministry? Which of the following bank has launched Nivesh, a new banking service in partnership with Pay Nearby? So guys, can you make a guess that which bank is it? The right answer here is SBM India. SBM stands for State Bank of Mauritius, not Maldives. Remember, State Bank of Mauritius, India, and it has partnered with Pay Nearby, which is a fintech startup. So these two organizations have launched this new facility called Nivesh, and this is a neobanking facility. What is a neobank? Neobank is a new term for banks that operate online. So neobank equals to online banks that have no store in brick, that have no brick and mortar store. They operate online and their entire operation goes through online applications. So this is a new kind of application being provided by SBM India and Pay Nearby Start. Now guys, the thing about SBM India that you need to remember is that it is the first foreign bank that received banking license from RBI in 2019. So banking license as in to operate as a bank in India. So that's an interesting fact, and you can remember it very well. Okay. Who has won the International Children's Peace Prize 2020? So this International Children's Peace Prize is provided by Kids Rights NGO. Now this NGO is based in Amsterdam, Netherlands. Remember the headquarters of this NGO as well. So this is a very reputed international children's NGO, and this provides this International Peace Prize for children's peace prize basically. Now this year in 2020, it has been won by Sadat Rahman, who is from Bangladesh. Remember this thing that his country is Bangladesh, can be after the examination. Now the other thing that you remember about him is that he has won this award for his initiatives towards cyber bullying. So in order to curb cyber bullying, he created an app as well as an organization at such a young age, and he won this International Children's Peace Prize. So he is basically a teenager, and he has done so much in order to curb cyber bullying. So bravo to this kid. Okay, now it's time for us to move on to the next question. What is the theme of World Diabetes Day? First of all, when is this day observed? It is observed on November 14 by WHO. Remember this thing? Last year, the question aaya tha World Diabetes Day. Mein se theme hi pucha tha. No, not theme. I guess day pucha tha. RBI ne aaya tha question. You can check it through our website. Past years are available on the website. So, World Diabetes Day is important. It was asked last year as well. So, there are chances that it can be asked again. Now, what is the theme of 2020? The theme is the nurse and diabetes. So you have to remember the theme. We have discussed the day and the theme. Now it's time to discuss the next question. Which of the following organization has won the UNESCO Madanjit Singh Prize for the Promotion of Tolerance and Nonviolence 2020? First of all, this award was given on the occasion of International Day of Tolerance. And when is this day observed? That is your task to find out. You have to tell me that when is this day observed. Now, which organization has won this award? The right answer is Center for Resolution of Conflicts, which is in Democratic Republic of Congo. So this organization has won this award, UNESCO Madanjit Singh Prize for the Promotion of Tolerance and Nonviolence 2020. Now comes our next question, which is who is the chairperson of Press Council of India? So this question comes up from National Press Day. So this day is observed on November 16 by India, and on this day Press Council of India was established in 1966. Remember the year Press Council of India was established on this day, or basically to commemorate the establishment of that organization, this day is observed. Now guys, you have to tell me the chairman of this council. The chairman is option A, Justice Chandramouli Kumar Prasad. So this is the answer of this question, and that's all. There is no theme for this year, for this day. So remember the date and the chairperson of Press Council of India, as well as the year in which this organization was established. So this is the last question for the day. Statue of Peace has been established, has been inaugurated by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. So where is this located? It is located in Rajasthan in Pali district. Remember the district as well. It can be asked. Pali district, Rajasthan, the Statue of Peace. Now, in whose honor was this Statue of Peace built? It was built in the honor of Vijay Vallabh Sureshwar Ji Maharaj. So he is a social reformist as well as an activist who actively participated in independence movement as well of India. So in order to honor his 151st birth anniversary, this Statue of Peace was built in Pali district, Rajasthan. So that's all for this session. I hope that you have really enjoyed the session. And if you have, then do give us a thumbs up so that we can also be motivated and come back with the same kind of content. Thank you so much for watching the video.